Okay, good morning and welcome to Ian on Mishnah. Today we're going to be analyzing Maseches Trumos, Perek Aleph, Mishnah Dalet. Take off Trumos min hazeisim al shemen anavim min hayayin. You're taking off Truma from olives on olive oil. So you can't. It's not the same thing. A liquid is not the same thing as a solid. It's like all the Mishnah Hay where you're mechayev al chiyav al ptur, ptur al chiyav. It's ineffective. It doesn't work. That's the stum of the Mishnah, anonymous Mishnah, Mishnah. Hey, all these things, you take off Truma. If something's potter from Truma, it's chulin, it's potter from Truma. You can't make that Truma to potter something else. And if something is chayim in Truma, you can't use that to exempt something which just doesn't need to be taken Truma off of because it's ineffective. Right? That's the stum of the Mishnah. Now, Beis Shammai is an interesting shita over here. Vim Tarmu, if you did it, Beis Shammai Truma's Atzman Behem, if you took off olives and olive oil, both are chayim in Truma, but you can't take off one on the other. They're not the same thing. One's a liquid, one's a solid. Technically, Beis Shammai holds that it has the status of truma. The olives are truma. But it didn't potter the olive oil. So you have to go take off truma again from the olive oil. It's sort of penalized. You have to take off truma twice. But the Selam Rim, it's ineffective. What's Machlokas Beis Shammai? So I want to say it's Machlokas basically in the Rambam and the Raivin, maybe. Whether the mitzvah of Rosh Truma is two mitzvahs or one mitzvah. It's just a mitzvah to free up your pile of produce that is no longer tevel, or is there, and that's the same mitzvah, and it's only one mitzvah to do that, and to give it to a kohen is included in one mitzvah, or is there two mitzvahs, first to potter it, and then to give it to a kohen? So the fact that Beis Shammai says you can have this situation over here where it becomes truma, but in terms of giving to the kohen, you're penalized, you have to give two portions to the kohen. Already, you see that Beis Shammai holds that the mitzvah is two mitzvahs, right? The mitzvah of truma is the chalos truma, declaring it as truma. And even though you're going to be penalized, you have to give twice to the kohen. It doesn't make a difference. That's not part of the mitzvah. The mitzvah, that's a separate mitzvah that Beis Shammai learns. A separate mitzvah, first you take off truma, you potter, you have a chalos. And then the second mitzvah is to give the kohen. So here you have to give twice the kohen. Still says it's ineffective because it's all one mitzvah. If you can't give the right amount to the kohen, you have to give double to the kohen, so therefore it's ineffective, right? Mechiv al-ptur, it's ineffective at all, because the whole purpose of Rosh Truma, making a halos truma, is to be able to give it to the kohen. If you can't give it to the kohen in the proper proportions, so it invalidates the Rosh Truma. Rosh Truma has to enable you to be not just the potter of the kri, but also to be able to give it to the kohen. Hope you enjoyed today's shir. See you on Motzei Shabbos, or maybe Sunday.